You know, I don't remember that area's name, but it should totally be named Dark Forest if it isn't. I think maybe I should take a sign down there when we go and maybe give it a new honorary title because, oh my God, talk about a forbidding forest indeed. And hey gang, this is Stormy. Thank you guys back to Nightmare Realm. And it's not all forbidding forests. Some of it is very warm, very happy, very bright, very yay, make Stormy a happy, happy girl. Sandstone place, traps of doom and gloom. Cheaty snow place, and now, whoa, God, I need to fix all this up here still. Now that I have an iron pick, I will. So yeah, I did a little bit of updating over here, gave it a little bit just warmer look, I think. I like it better. Warm, you know, no pun intended, as I almost step in fire. But yeah, planted some bushes, put up a some wood fence instead of the fire fence, I guess, so to speak, just to kind of, it feels a little bit like we are finally starting to whoops, tame a little bit of the map. Not all of it by any means. Look over there, look over there, look over. But this little corner here feels a little more under control, I suppose, because yeah, been quite a production to try to get things as quiet and tame as we have. This looks nice, by the way. I had to expand our storage room because of all the stuff we got. Mostly this stuff. That's tremendous. Some of this though, you know, we've got all our stuff here, but also I went ahead, whoops. I went ahead and organized this according to the number. That was wool number 9 that we got last episode, you guys, in the sandstone place. I feel like that was a really, really lucky pick of a place to go because we got cobblestone, we got iron, and if that was the 9th wool, we were a little bit ahead of schedule. So that worked out in our favor. Yeah, I feel very, and I don't feel bad about it at all, you know, because the dungeons aren't numbered, so I'm like, yep, that was lucky. So yeah, see, I tend to catch myself fiddling like this a lot, especially now that I have a little bit faster pick for dealing with this kind of thing. Now I was going to make a honey pot out of that down there. It occurred to me, well, first of all, I was going to do it, and then I wanted to wait till I was recording because there's 4 gas spawners in a fun box over there. That's gonna be significant to take out. But it occurred to me also that's gonna take a massive crap ton of blocks. So this, I think, would be a more logical honey pot because it is its own area. Most of it is far enough away from the main land, I guess, that skeletons over there aren't going to shoot at us. Should be fairly easy to block off, I think, just with a big wall across the walkway in. And yeah, I think that's logical. Also, you know, I brought an iron axe so that we can get you know, a little bit more wood, but I was thinking what we can do is we can use flint and steel, fire, light the trees on fire as a way to light up the area, and that will burn out on its own somewhat and eventually and it'll darken itself. So yeah. Seems reasonable. Could take a while to burn out, but it'll still a lot of it I think will still be dark, so it should work. It should. I don't know, but we're gonna try. I'm trying to figure out where I hear all these monsters. Now, I know that this area is still pretty wild and woolly because when we came through here before, we didn't have torches and I did not want to put fire everywhere. So I was being pretty careful with how where I lit fire. Oh God! Where did you come from? Hey! What is Oh, just the thing. Okay. Cool. That is. Really? I hope you guys can't hear my dog. When I started recording, he decided to bring his food bowl in and lay behind me and crunch. So sorry. My only concern is that the fires will take too long to burn out. But we don't have to light up the whole area because I really don't think there's going to be a lot over there. I mean, we'll check and see, but yeah, now this is going to be tough because of the spawns being pretty concentrated. But I guarantee that this dungeon would have come before the one we just did. So he wouldn't expect us to necessarily have iron armor. So that'll help offset some of the issues with the damn it. Some of the issues with the I had to stop and scratch my eye. Some of the issues with the spawns. What am I trying to say? Dang it. It got well, like I said, it's going to be nuts with the number of spawns we're gonna have. And of course, baby cave spiders just, you know, they add a definite degree of challenge. Now I'm hoping that the fires don't lag us too badly. Wow, look at that. Look at this. Wonder if that arrow is gonna be in that screenshot. I wonder if that screenshot is gonna look any good. I had to try. I'd love it if it did, though. Ah! God, we are so close to void here. Now, I'm kind of trying to hurry because of the fires. I don't want them to have a chance to burn out before we're done in here. But this way, the reason I'm doing it this way, whoa, I almost caught myself on fire. The reason I'm doing it this way is obviously because yeah, the fires burn out themselves, and I don't have to pick up torches, which is dangerous. I made a honey pot in the area where the cyan wool was. Wow. And I don't know if you guys noticed that I had all the cyan wool. That's because I made a honey pot in the area of the sandstone dungeon where the wool box, ooh, a record, where the wool box was, like I said I was going to. And I thought, well, I don't want to leave, you know, I don't want to leave the wool in here if this is going to be a honey pot. So I will take the wool out and I'll put it, you know, somewhere safe. Well, I made it all the way back to base and realized I'd forgotten to take all the wool out of my pocket. So after being very, very thankful that I had not, you know, like swan dived into the void with all the wool in my pocket, I, you know, yeah. But that was that. Vines burn, right? Yeah, vines burn. If you can, you know, get the fire on them, I guess. Ah! Ow. Here, slime, land in a oops, fire. Ow, dang it, I've got to. I keep for. I. Erg. Putting the fire on the ground is dangerous because I keep walking through it because I keep, like, you know, forgetting that I can't do that. Yikes. The void. The, uh-oh. Oh. Oh. Okay, cool. Dude, go away! That scared the crap out of me. Oh, I do want to get a spruce sapling, though. Dang it, go away, spider. Ow. Ow, that slime is wrecking me. Damn, because we're hungry. And there went our flint steel. Yeah, I want a spruce sapling just so that I can get spruce wood should I want it. So we need to do that. Let's come over here and punch this spruce tree over here. Come here, tree. That's gonna be a baby. Yep, I knew it. Ah! It's gonna be a creeper. I'll put a few torches down. Damn it! I want spruce. Give me spruce. That's gonna be another baby. I want a spruce sapling! Oh, there's a couple babies. Get! Of course, as is the way with cave spiders, I can't hit them until they poison me. Where are you, you little... Ugh. I hate cave spiders. Hard to hit. Seriously, if I die right after I get full iron armor, I'm gonna be salty. Although, it would be because of the cave spiders. I retreated. I was smart. I retreated. I can't dig in, you know, because there's a little bit of a problem. That's pretty awesome looking. That was a big tree. Well, I suppose on the bright side, if I do end up needing to use torches, at least they'll be easier to pick up. I won't have to use as many, maybe. Whoops, I spilled my mic. Am I healed up somewhat yet? How's our armor? It's good. It's there. It's there. It's wonderful. I have an iron, or I mean an armor bar now instead of, you know, just food and health there, and it's so nice. Okay. Where's a spruce sapling? Just need one. Just one. Need one. Please, can I have one? That looks cool. Wow, I need to try to get a screenshot of that, actually. That's pretty awesome looking. Sorry, I don't know why that looks so cool. It just does. Ow! Damn it, go away! Where's your spawner? I was hoping I had at least lit it up. Must be down here on this hill, because it's still dark there. Get, oh my god. Those shits are gonna kill me, because they're like, not there, and then they're suddenly there. Which makes sense if I'm standing on top of a spawner, but I'm not sure where their spawner is. Have I gotten a spruce sapling yet? No. You know what I need to do is go cut down the tree and then run off. Wait, I need to wait until I heal. Sorry, guys. I'm enjoying being able to just derp around. You know, I haven't really been able to do that without definite risk. I mean, you know, it's risky enough. I'm liable to die to these damn cave spiders. But, it's not as bad as it was before. That's regular spiders. I was like, man, cave spider. Oh, you're a creeper. You know what? Go ahead and blow that up. Because sometimes, yes! That can be a quick, way to get a sapling. Is by letting a creeper blow up the tree and just hope he doesn't blow up the sapling. Why can't I run? And there's a creeper blocking my escape. Terrific. Fantastic. That went exactly as if I had planned every bit of it. You have a glowy bow. And you're coming for me and you have a glowy bow. How about no? How about you give me that glowy bow? See, I don't need it so badly anymore. See? He gave it to me. I have armor now, so I, you know, a glowy bow is not as needed. What's on it? Hey, it's got its power one, which isn't, that's not fantastic, but damn it, it glows. I'm happy with that. Go away, you little demon spawn hell minion nyerg. Creepy little bastards. Where are you guys coming from? Well, at least I got my spruce sapling, so I can, you know. Oh my god, seriously. Get off of me before you kill me dead. Where? 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 They seem to be coming from here. I'll have to pick all these torches up, I guess. Man, we are making amazing progress, aren't we, pets? Like, we are moving fast through this dungeon so far. We have lit up almost none of it because all our fire is burned out. I have been having fun with the map, but the supplies we found last episode were a much welcome morale boost. Hi, skeleton. How are ya? Where are ya? Oh, there you are. Oops. Wait. Oops. Wait. You didn't wait. You didn't wait. Ah! Get around the block! God. Stood there for a minute, just kind of slowly. Oh. I was like, what's in the tree? An arrow. Away. I'm trying to do something and you're bugging me. So long are you. Where are you guys? Okay, there's a cave spider. I really probably should do something about that cave spider problem that we're having because they're dangerous. In case you guys didn't know. That's bad news. I don't know why I'm so hellbent to get that last piece of wood. It doesn't really matter. Does a creeper want to come blow me up a oak sapling now? Like, that'd be awesome. That's spruce. That's not oak. And that's a cave spider. This reminds me of Canopy Carnage, which I've played part of. Not sure I'd want to play it on my channel, but, you know, someday. Maybe. I don't know. I have a pretty good idea of what I'm going to do after I finish this. Although that's subject to change, so I don't want to say anything. You guys have seen it happen before where I, you know, I think I know what I'm going to do and then I change my mind. But, I think I know what I want to do. Hi, guys. Beck sure did like Enderman spawners. I don't recall him using this many Enderman spawners in later maps. Like, you just don't see them much. Doesn't seem like. I know we had one in waking up. Damn, I used all my torches. I'm not using my flint and steel as much as I anticipated because, well, I was, but it's kind of a problem. I'll just have to go around and pick up my torches, I guess. You know what would be great? And yes, I realize there's a skeleton standing there on that on that log just shooting me. It's a little bit problematic in that, I completely forgot what to say. Never mind. What the hell? I just heard all these zombies fall, it sounded like. Oh, wait. Wait, no. This is probably bad. Also, this is a bigger island than I thought. So, making it a honeypot is obviously gonna have to, be done carefully. And probably not the whole damn thing. So I am going to have to go get more torches. Wow. That's a big place. I thought it was smaller than that. But it loops around, or, well, not loops around, but it goes around back there, too. Getting a little bit framey. Which I should not be, despite the fire. My computer should be able to handle that. But apparently, it's been in a mood lately. I know it's been in a mood, and I don't know why. But it's getting on my nerves. So... whatever. Wow, look at that! Okay, I suppose that could be making it framey, actually. Wow. I wish I knew if there's any reason to explore the rest of the area, but I have to anyway. Now, that down there might be something. Might be. Can't quite tell. Wow. Gosh. Cool. Alright. So I think, like I said, making that a honeypot is gonna have to be done, like, part of it. Like, I don't know, maybe that part of it. Something. Just like not even put up a wall, just like go take up all the torches from like that portion of it or something. And then just like put up a fence along right there. Cause we've got tons of fences around the map that we can harvest to our heart's content. That down there would be good. It's just I'd have to take out all the spawners. And it would be a lot of blocks to block it up. Eh, whatever. I'll figure it out. Soon, and it's going to have to be done soon because dark areas are becoming a serious problem with the spawns in them. So obviously I'm gonna have to take care of it pretty soon. Because that down there needs to not I'm out of torches, needs to not be dark because monsters can spawn down there and find their way to our base. I need to light all this up now that we have unlimited wood and lots of coal now, you know, that we can just go mine. I got some of those gold picks, by the way, that were in that one chest, so that kind of helped. All right, so I'm going to get some torches and reconjigger my plans for the area because it's bigger than I thought it was, and I will be back with you guys, okay? Sit tight. Oh, did I show you guys in here? Yeah, I must have because I showed you guys the chests. I mean, I don't think I said anything. I just walked out, but I mean, you guys would have seen. Isn't this nicer? Like, doesn't this just feel better? I decided, by the way, not to replace the cobble because we don't need to anymore. And there are still 4 active gas spawners plus an active dungeon with at least 1 gas spawner wherever the hanging things are over there, maybe. You know, that one. And I mean, okay, if a ghast blows up the fence or the leaves, whatever. But this at least is ghast proof. So, yeah. Anyway, all right, I will be. By the way, look at what level we are. Wow, 41. I'm in unenchanted iron armor. We're level 41, and it just kind of makes me want to cry. Ooh, I should get an anvil. All right, I'll be back. Okay, gang, we're back. I went ahead and grabbed some more torches, and I'm hoping I didn't lose too much track of what I'm doing because I recorded the first part of this episode last night, and I've slept since then, but I was just too tired to keep going last night because I ran around so much yesterday, hopefully I did not lose my train of thought. I don't know if I even realized there was a tree that close to here, but when you step down, let's see, right there, that's where the doing, 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 going. Okay, sorry. Anyway, so let's stand 1 block higher and figure this out. So like I was saying, I think to do this as a honeypot, we're going to have to just do part of it as a honeypot because, yeah. This is obviously a very big area. Can I? Yes, I can. That was probably needlessly risky, but I think this is an oak tree and I wanted some oak sapling, so this is probably a good time to get that because monsters, shh, don't know we're here. Shh, no, we're hunting sapling, and the evil powers that be will try to stop us from getting the sapling of world saving, the sapling of happiness, the sapling of, okay, fine, I just want an oak sapling. We have a spruce sapling. I put that in our chest so that it's nice and safe and out of the reach of the evil forces that be in Nightmare Realms. What are the evil forces, I wonder? Like, ooh. Ah, damn. Maybe these are birch leaves and not spruce or oak leaves. Maybe. I don't know. I know I should quit using my axe to break them. Maybe these are birch leaves, in which case that's going to do us no good. Hi, you guys are trying to come find me, but I don't think you guys can get to me, can you? Is there anything we can do from here? Like, this feels like a very powerful position, you know, where we could totally accomplish something, but damned if I know what. Yeah, this is spruce. Well, that sucks. There's a cave spider under us. I haven't found a single cave spider spawner. I don't know where they are. Crap. They're gathering under us. We need to move. Because that's just gonna create a problem. Damn it! Get jump, you fool. Do you not realize there's like void underneath you? Go away. Go away. Thank you. Creeper landed on me as I was walking over here and damn near killed me. That one block is driving me nuts and I can't do anything about it. I don't know, I could have a creeper blow it up. That would be okay. God, I so wish for a lava bucket. I swear, if I knew who to sweet talk for a lava bucket, I would sweet talk them, but I don't. Let's see, let's just go. Let's just kind of run. We know the wool box is over here somewhere, so let's just see what we can accomplish. I don't need another Enderman spawner. We've got a few of those already. I don't want to stop and fight, damn it. I'm doing a sort of a kind of a torch run here. Ow. And if I stop and fight, everything's gonna catch me, and I don't want that to happen. I really like this area. Whoa. Aw, man. Like, this is about the prettiest area I've seen so far in this map. There's not a lot of pretty in this map. So this is nice. I like this. So I'm only gonna make part of it the honey pot, I think. And whoa. And then that way, you know, if I need a dose of pretty, we can come over here anytime we want. What's that about? Just a thing, probably. Now I know there are cave spiders. Like I said, I can't seem to find any of their spawners, but there are cave spiders. Was a thought. What is glowstone about here? Oh, hey! An oak sapling. Sweet. I see you over there playing peekaboo. Ah! I couldn't. Oh, there were leaves behind me. I couldn't back up out of his line of sight, and he blew up. There's a hole in my beautiful area. I love this place. It's like so pretty. Hi, creeper. How about just die? I don't really want to be stuck in a hole while you're. There's a chest on top of that glowstone right there. Do you guys see what I see? Do you see what I see? I see water. There. Let's protect it. Let's hop up here so we can get shot off by a skeleton. How about that? Oh, nice. Nice. So nice. Melon seeds and grass seeds. Not that we need those, but well, they're there. The melon seeds are nice, though. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Let's stand up here and take a look around. Ooh, I see mushrooms over there. The wool box is up there, but there's a lot yet to explore. Obviously, I didn't bring a bucket, but well, you know. I like this area because I like how Vex does custom trees. And there are custom trees in here, so it makes me happy. Let's run and oh gosh. Oh gosh, there's a cave spider. Yep, hi cave spider. I'm going the wrong way. Follow the torches, Stormy. No, creeper! It's a circle of glowstone? Let's hop up. Because it seems like it might be something. I know you guys can't see too well, and I am sorry. I really wish I had a night vision potion right now. That would be handy as crap. I've decided I don't want to burn all these trees, so. I'll burn the trees wherever I decide to do a honeypot. Okay, so that is the main island. I thought for a minute maybe I had found another island, but no, that's the main one. I'm just facing a different way than I thought I was. So let's go this way. Just kind of taking a look around. Because we're almost out of time for this episode, so I figure take a look and see. What is that over there? Is that that one area that we have to bridge to that we already know about, or is that something different? I don't know. Those are interesting looking trees right there. Huh. I think there's more to this area than I thought there was, which is cool because I do like this area quite a bit. Put some light down for you guys. How did I get up here? Ooh, there's an Enderman spawner. There we go. I do need more ender pearls, but like I said, this is not the place for it. So. Although, thank you. Could be handy. Oh, I didn't look at you! And there's a creeper. Don't blow up my thing! Don't blow up! There's another Enderman spawner. I think there's a creeper. Is there a creeper still following me around? No. Okay, that's good. I'm scared he's gonna blow up our water source block that we finally found. If only I could find a lava source block. I thought this area was gonna be mostly cave spiders, but it seems to be mostly Enderman. There was a spawner. I saw it. I was gonna take it out. Now I can't find it. We need to go back this way. Fortunately, the water block is marked by a great big tall tower. But I can't, damn it! Where are you guys coming from? More torches down, I guess. Since I can't find their spawner, all I can do is fight it with light. Hi, creeper. I knew you were behind me. I mean, I knew there was something behind me, and I knew it was a creeper. So, yeah, I knew you were behind me, like I said to begin with. See what I did there? I don't. Where are you guys coming from? Like, oops. This should be mostly lit up, I thought. So we are finally getting some things that are really going to help us, I think, because we finally got a water source block. We've got iron. And this is an interesting area. I'm looking forward to looking around it more. I really, really, really wish we had night vision potions. That's an area where that kind of thing would be super happy, helpful. But we don't. So I guess what I'm going to have to... Although, the parts of it that are down in the void fog is not good with a night vision potion, so maybe it's a good thing we don't. Also, I was thinking about this again. How many ladders do I have? Haha, none. Oh, right, I didn't bring any. I didn't figure I'd need them for the trees. I think what we can probably do is go ahead and take out those spawners up there, take out the fun box, and probably put a fence, you know, across here and just leave that dark rather than walling it all in. Skeletons, or I could do what somebody suggested and dig a 3-deep trench. Either way, skeletons are going to be able to shoot at us, but I need honey pots. So yeah, you guys. So that'll be something to do before we move on. I know that the area we found in the sandstone place, like I said, it's not technically another intersection, but it feels like another, well, an intersection. without being one. So, because obviously, really, obviously, there's, you know, portion of the map we haven't even found yet that is, well, somewhere. I don't know where, but somewhere. Because, we haven't found 16, oh, geez. We haven't found 16 dungeons worth of, well, 16 dungeons. So, yeah, obviously there's part of this we haven't yet found. Or dungeons we haven't found anyway, so... And I'm assuming that we're, that it's probably out beyond the render distance. I mean, I'm guessing. I don't know, obviously, but I'm guessing so. I still am not putting wool on the, whoa, sorry, wool on the monument, because nuts to that. That feels like just a bad idea. Whew, do I have time to go get the, not really. Not without making the episode longer than I like to make the episodes. But we're finally going to be able to farm. The only problem is I can't, like, with only one water block, I don't want to take it with us, you know, into other, like, for lava or whatever, because we've only got the one, obviously. And if I lose it, well, there it goes. So... Yeah, it's going to stay here. I want to make a safe place to farm, I think. So that I can, well, grow potatoes, because what I've been doing, like I said, is just bone mealing the potatoes. Well, then I have to bone meal the potatoes. Anyway, shut up, Stormy. It is time to say goodnight and end the episode. Well, not goodnight. It's like noon. But... It is time to end the episode. Between episodes, what am I going to do? Much of anything? I can't do anything with that because I need to do that on camera. Because taking out 4 gas spawners and a fun box is, well, it's dangerous. Yeah, probably not a whole lot of off-camera work. I'll get that water next time we go in there. So, yeah, next episode we'll continue in the tree area, and once we're done with that, we'll probably move to the snow area. So, everybody, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all real soon. Take care. I'll get this eventually. I'll get this all nice and tidy. Anyway, bye now.